I'm pretty excited to introduce you to a new feature we just released in the router. It's called custom telemetry. It will give you more flexibility around telemetry, and it will extend the existing features we already have in the router around telemetry. Let's say we have a query to have a list of products. All the information about name, price are coming from the product service, and this review with the body is coming from the reviews service, which is basically a subgraph in GraphQL. So when executing this query, I'm receiving an error. The message is not really obvious. We also have the error code right here, which could be pretty useful, but with that data, we won't have enough details to know what's going on and how to fix it. It's now possible for us to add more context around this and be able to debug it. So let's see the configuration file of the router. It's a YAML file. Here I have the spans section. I'm able to add some new attributes on our own spans. We're just saying that if we have a GraphQL error in the response body, we will just set this hotel status code attribute as an error. So the value of this attribute will be error. And we will do the same for the subgraph. We will also include the subgraph name in attributes for the subgraph span. And we will add the hotel status code as an error. Thanks to this, now we know that if there is an error, we will have spans marked as an error. To have more context and to be able to debug, we will need some events, some logs. To achieve that, we will add events at the subgraph level. We will have to dump the row request, the row response, and the error if we have an error. So let's save that and see what happens when I re-execute the same query. For now, here it's the same answer, it's the same response. But if we're going to your preferred APM, application performance monitoring, here we are using New Relic, but you could use your own one like Datadog, for example. We can see that we have errors right here on the dashboard. So let's click on this to have more context and more details about what's going on. And we executed the products query. So we have traces for this query. Here it is. We had some query for products in error. So let's see. Here we can see all the spans created for that request. This one is marked as an error. The status code is in error. And we also have the status description. We can see that the subgraph name is reviews. And we can also have more context thanks to events we added. And we have the response event from the subgraph reviews. And we can see that the http.response.body, which is basically the response body, was containing an error. And it's explaining us that you must not set the header insecure. So now let's go back. Now we know what's going on. We previously set an insecure header. Let's disable this and re-execute it. So now it's working as expected. So that's pretty powerful. Okay, so now we saw how to debug your application thanks to traces and events. We didn't mention and use instruments. Instruments are pretty useful if you want to monitor your GraphQL application. Not to debug it, but to monitor having more values from your business data. So we will use another query called product, only one product. It will fetch a product with the name, the price, and the review. So we have the price here, it's 14. When executing this, what I would like to do is to know how much product with that price has been fetched. For example, you can create a custom counter with the data coming directly from the response body only by writing configuration in the YAML. So I just have to add a new instrument at the supergraph level, which is called product.price. The value will fetch the data from the response body directly. It will create a counter with the units in dollars, and we will also add an attribute on this metric to know on which kind of device this query has been executed. So let's re-execute it again, and we can directly go on New Relic. I created a small dashboard to see the counter has been incremented twice because we executed the query twice. And so now, as the real price was 14, we have 28 as a value in the dashboard. As you can see with this new feature, you're now able to create your own custom metrics and traces and so on. And that's really powerful because without having to write any line of code, without having to compile the router and so on, you're now able to provide more context and debug. You'll be able to empower your users in a better way.